concept of trigonometric Fourier series and various symmetries that are related to a trigonometric Fourier series. Okay. So basically, when you want to write down a Fourier series, what are the essential conditions? The essential conditions which are satisfied in order to determine the Fourier series are called as Dirichlet conditions. Now, what are the Dirichlet conditions that need to be satisfied by a function in order to determine its Fourier series? Is first one that the function must be periodic. Okay. Second one, finite number of discontinuity in one time period t. Third, finite number of maxima and minima in one time period t. And the last one, absolutely integrable. What is meant by absolutely integrable? Integration over one time period of the magnitude of that function should be fine. So these are the four conditions that need to be satisfied by a function in order for you to determine its Fourier series. Now, Fourier series is nothing but it is the representation of a function or a periodic function as a linear combination of harmonically related sinusoids or complex exponentials. What is meant by this term harmonically related? Harmonically related functions are those where the frequency of all the functions are multiple of the same fundamental frequency. That is, if frequency of all the sinusoids are nothing but integral multiple of a single frequency, they are said to be harmonically related. The reason behind that being, when two sinusoids have different frequency, they are orthogonal to each other. So what we are essentially doing is, we are representing a periodic function as a sum of mutually orthogonal functions. It is similar to what we do for vectors, that is, a vector can be expressed as a linear combination of orthogonal vectors like 3i plus 4j plus 5k. Here I, j, k are mutually orthogonal vectors. Similarly, in Fourier series, we express a function as a sum of mutually orthogonal functions which are harmonically related sinusoids or which are complex exponentials. Now, when you want to write down trigonometric Fourier series, that is, if you wish to express the function as linear combination of sine and cos. So, how you express a function x of t? You express it as a naught plus summation from k equal to 1 to infinity ak cos k omega naught t plus summation k equal to 1 to infinity bk sine k omega naught t. That is, a linear combination of this term, this is called as DC or average term. Okay, in linear combination with harmonically related cosine function, harmonically related sine function. Harmonically related because all their frequencies are multiple of omega naught, that is omega naught, 2 omega naught, 3 omega naught, like that. Now, how to find out these values a naught, ak and bk? A naught is given by 1 upon t. T is the time period of the function, integration over t, x of t, dt. That is, I am doing nothing but I am taking the average of the function, xt. Ak is 2 by t integral over t x of t cos k omega naught t dt. Bk is 2 by t integration over t x of t sine k omega naught t dt. Integration over t means you can either integrate it from 0 to t, you can integrate it from minus t by 2 to plus t by 2, you can integrate it from minus t by 4 to plus 3t by 4. That is, the interval of integration must be t, no matter what are the limits. You can integrate it from 3t to 4t, but the limit difference of the limits must always be t. Now there are some properties that you need to remember. That is, first of all, for even function means x of minus t is equal to x of t. Here bk is 0 because in bk we have sine. Sine is odd function. A0 and ak are non-zero. For an odd function means x of minus t is equal to minus of xt. Here a0 and ak are 0 but bk is non-zero. Then the last one, for half wave symmetry, what is meant by half wave symmetry? X of t plus t by 2 is minus of xt. So how you can graphically visualize this? That is, the half cycle of the waveform should be exactly negative of the other half cycle. Think of it as sine wave. In sine, the graph that you have from 0 to pi, it is like this. Then for other half cycle, you just have its mirror image like this. So it is called as half wave symmetry. That is, the graph for one half cycle is exactly the negative for the other half cycle. That is called as half wave symmetry. Here only k must be odd. In this Fourier series, k cannot take even values, that is 2, 4, 6, 8, k cannot take those values. It can only be odd, that is 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. So that is called as half wave symmetry. Now sometimes this half wave symmetry may not be visible directly. We'll have to identify whether or not a function is half wave symmetric. So see it like this. Suppose I give you one waveform, you have to identify whether or not it is half wave symmetric. Like this. Okay? 1, 3, 4, 6, then it will be 7. Okay? Suppose it is like this. Now at first, there is no negative part, so you may be tempted to say that it is not half wave symmetric. How can this condition be satisfied if the waveform itself does never go negative? But that is not entirely correct actually. So whenever you see this kind of waveform, the first thing that you have to do is find average. Here if you want to find out average, see, here the period of the waveform is, period of the waveform is 6. This point is repeated here. So area upon duration. Area you take up to 6. Up to 6 you have one trapezoid. Let me also define the height as 2. So here we have one trapezoid. Area of trapezoid is how much? Half into sum of parallel sides. Parallel side is 4 and 2. Into height, that is 2 by t. So average will come out to be 1. So the average of the function is 1, then the next step that you follow is subtract the average from the function. Remove the average. If you shift the function downwards by its average, then how will it become? It will become something like this. Subtract 1 from this. This 2 will come to 1 and 0 will go to minus 1. Function will now start from minus 1 instead of 0. What I am doing is I am subtracting average from each point. So it will go to 1 at 1. Then it will stay at 1 up to 3. Then it will come to minus 1 at 4. Then it will stay up at minus 1 up to 6. Then it will go up to 1 on 7. So now if you see, you can clearly see that this is a half wave symmetric waveform. The half wave, the positive half wave like this one, the other half is negative of this. So we can say only odd harmonics will exist. That is, k can only take odd values, it will be 0 for even values. Okay? If you continue drawing it here, you will see waveform like this. Okay? So if I ask you whether it is odd or even, now if you see, the waveform is not symmetric in first and third quadrant. It is not odd. It is not symmetric in first and second. It is neither even. So it is neither even nor odd. Is it fine? So it is neither even nor odd because it is neither symmetric in first and third quadrant nor it is symmetric in first and second quadrant. Now that is how you check the half wave symmetry. It is sometimes also referred to as hidden symmetry. To determine hidden symmetry, you first have to subtract the average of the function from the function itself and then you will look for half wave symmetry. Now let me take a waveform and derive the Fourier series for you. This question was asked in GATE in power electronics, but it is actually from signals and system. So let me give you one waveform. Okay, it is somewhat like this. This is one period of the waveform. This is 100, minus 100. This angle is 2 pi. So you can have either the x-axis in terms of time, that is t, or you can also have in terms of omega t or the angle. So this angle I am giving you as alpha, 180 minus alpha, 180, 180 plus alpha, 360 minus alpha, and this one is 2 pi or 360. So first let us check for even and odd. How you check for even and odd basically? You first have to draw the waveform in the negative region. How you draw in negative region? You subtract, listen to me carefully, you subtract 360 from all the points. So if you subtract 360 from 360, you will go to 0. Subtract 360 from 360 minus alpha, that is, it will be minus alpha. So now if you see, this waveform is symmetric in first and the third quadrant. If it is symmetric about origin or in first and third quadrant, it is a odd function. Okay, because this width is also alpha, this width is also alpha. It is odd function. Now can you guess about the half wave symmetry, whether it is half wave symmetric? So see, first of all, this width is alpha, this width is 180 minus 2 alpha, this width is again alpha. So see the mirror image, alpha, this width is again alpha, but here value becomes negative, plus 100, minus 100, this width, minus 100, it goes to plus 100. This width is again alpha, plus 100 again comes to minus 100. So this half wave is basically mirror image of the first one, hence it is half wave symmetric. If the one half wave is mirror image of the other half wave, then it is said to be half wave symmetric and here only odd harmonics will exist. In the question, they told you that fundamental RMS is 50 volt. Find alpha. So that means we have to calculate the fundamental RMS. Now here, as you know, it is odd function, only BK will be non-zero. Fundamental means K will be 1, so I have to evaluate B1. B1 will be, the period is 2 pi, integration from 0 to 2 pi, function xt, K you are taking as 1, sine omega naught t, and here x-axis is omega t or omega naught t. So now if you see, there are 6 intervals of integration from 0 to alpha. It is 100, sin omega naught t, d omega naught t. Then from alpha up to 180 minus alpha, it is minus 100 sine omega naught t d omega naught t. Then from 180 minus alpha up to 180, it is again 100 sine omega naught t d omega naught t. Then from 180 to 180 plus alpha, it is again minus 100 sin omega naught t d omega naught t. Then from 180 plus alpha to 360 minus alpha, it is 100 sin omega naught t d omega naught t. 360 minus alpha up to 360, it will be minus 100 sin omega naught t d omega naught t. Okay, so there are six integrations that we have to solve. Now in order to solve them in a short manner, try to do things sometimes in your head instead of writing them down. So let me show you how. Integration of sin x is actually minus cos x. Due to this minus sign, what I can do is I can take first lower limit and then subtract it from the upper limit, that is lower limit minus upper limit. Okay, I told you wrongly actually. I'll subtract the upper limit from the lower limit, that is lower limit minus upper limit. Every term has 100, so take this 100 common, 100 upon pi. Integration of sine is minus cos, so you will take lower minus upper. Cos of 0 is 1. Minus upper, cos of alpha is cos. Moving forward, here minus sign is already there. Integration of sine will be minus cos, minus minus plus. That means cos of upper limit, cos of 180 minus alpha, minus cos alpha, minus cos of lower limit, minus cos alpha. Moving forward, sine integration is minus cos, which means lower limit minus upper limit. So lower limit cos of 180 minus alpha, minus cos alpha, minus upper limit cos of 180 minus 1, minus minus will be plus. Sine integration minus cos, minus minus plus. So cos of upper limit minus cos alpha minus cos of 180, cos of 180 is minus 1, minus minus will be plus 1. Coming to this, integration of sine is minus cos, so cos of lower limit minus cos alpha minus cos of upper limit, so this will be actually 360 minus alpha, minus cos of upper limit will be minus cos alpha. Then sine minus cos, minus minus plus cos, which means upper limit minus lower limit, cos of 361, cos of 360 minus alpha minus cos alpha. So 1 is coming 4 times and cos alpha is coming 8 times. So 4 I am taking common, 1 minus 2 cos alpha. If the RMS value is 50, peak value is 50 root 2. This is basically peak value. If you solve for alpha from here, it is 77.15 degree. Okay, so that is how you can check half wave symmetry, even and odd function, and then you can calculate the coefficient of Fourier series, whether it is fundamental, second harmonic or third harmonic. A tricky question I could have asked like this. Suppose if I have asked you what is the second harmonic, you would have said 0, because the waveform that I showed you was half wave symmetric. So even harmonics cannot exist, only odd harmonics can exist. So it will come out to be 0. Is it fine? So that is all that you need to know about the trigonometric Fourier series. And sometimes the question can be lengthy as well. You may have to do a lot of computation. That is entirely possible. Okay, so this will be all from my side. Thank you.
So guys, if you found this content useful, please like and share it among your friends also, so that they can also learn the same concept. And if you want such more videos in the near future, you can suggest us the topic in the comment section. And you can also subscribe to our YouTube channel, because we'll be uploading videos on regular basis, so you can stay updated what is being uploaded and you can easily learn the concept. You don't have to search for the videos if you subscribe to our channel. Thank you.